Don't you people have anything better to do?
Can I help you, sir?
I'm Officer Phelps, miss. I'm here about the shooting. Did you know the victim?
He was my boss. Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage's first name?
Everett.
And you are?
Galleta. Clovis Galleta.
You think you could tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that I'm late on my lunch.
And?
We came back. I was angry. I walked in front. I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
You're lying, Miss Galletta. You know what happened and why. You're going to tell me.
There's nothing to tell. I've done nothing wrong. How can you prove different?
Your pearl earrings, Miss Galletta. You've been paying for them for a whole year. Stop lying and tell me what happened at the jewelry store.
Oh, God. I won't lose the earrings, will I?
You could lose your freedom, you little fool, if you don't stop obstructing a murder investigation.
Mr. Kalu. Edgar Kalu. He runs the jewelry store. He's showing me a lovely watch. Mr. Gage bursts in. Mr. Kalu gets very angry with Mr. Gage, and they start yelling at each other. Mr. Gage tells me that all of the things in the store are junk. Nickel-plated, made in Japan, and yells at me to get back to work.
Then what happened?
We get back here, and I hear a loud bang. Mr. Gage clutches at his back. I hear another bang, and another, and another. Mr. Gage falls to his knees. It looked very painful.
Which jewelry store?
Hartfield's. Broadway between 5th and 6th.
Did you see the person who shot Mr. Gage?
Of course I did. Mr. Kalu looked very angry. He kept firing the gun. He kept pulling the trigger. He threw the gun in a bin and turned and walked away.
Officially opening the nationwide March of Dimes campaign in Washington, Mrs. Truman and her daughter Margaret take part in the ceremonies at the Capitol.
You're making me angry, Miss Galletta. Is that what you want? Tell me why Mr. Kalu shot Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage hates Jews. A lot of people do. It's not my fault if he has nice things.
How many shots did you hear, Miss Galletta?
It's difficult to remember. It sounded like there were so many. And they were so loud.
I need you to concentrate, Miss Galletta. Even minor details can become important later on.
Well, there was one bang. And then another. And then three very quickly. Close together. Five.
Thank you for your help, ma'am. You've been very brave. We'll need you to make a formal statement about what happened, Mr. Cage.
Does that mean I can still collect my... my... Never mind. Yes, officer, I'll make a statement.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
I must look a mess.
We have the murder weapon.
And the murderer. The girl saw it all. Our killer works at a jewelry store called Hartfield's.
That's a couple of blocks from here.
Thinking what I'm thinking?
Tate, maintain the perimeter.
This is a secure area. You all need to leave. Show's over. Keep moving, all of you. You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Officers, what can I do you for?
Officers Phelps and Dunn, sir, Wilshire Division. We need you to trace a serial number.
Sure. What's the make and model?
F.N. Browning, model 1922. The serial number is 01138.
You don't say. Well, I didn't sell it. Europeans love them, but it's pretty rare you find one over here. Although I did have one in here a couple weeks back.
Remember the owner?
Yeah. Callow. Edgar Callow was his name. Thing looks like it'd never been fired, but he brought it in here for cleaning anyway. Then he bought a box of cartridges and he left.
You know where we can find Mr. Callow?
Told me he was on his lunch break. Said he worked at Hartfield's jewelry store just up on Broadway.
Thanks for your help. You can drive.
Officer, can I interest you in a new watch?
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Callow?
No. Mr. Callow is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go!
Hurry, officer! He's getting away!
Hello! Get back here!
Shoot the creep!
I'm out of here!
Shoot the creep!
Next time.
Too late, Callow!
You don't need this? find the advantage, you'll lose time to get through.
What the hell?
Stop or I will shoot!
God, help me! My goodness!
Edgar Kalu, you're under arrest for the murder of Everett Gage.
The case that makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solve, the one that keeps you awake at night. The case that gnaws at your guts and ruins your marriage. The case that keeps you propping up a bar as you relive the what-ifs, the might-have-beens, the half-leads, and the half-truths. The case that other cops murmur about whenever you walk past. The case you never, ever discuss.
God's mill may grind slowly, but it grinds finely, son. I hear it's you who nabbed our malefactor from the shooting yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber, a man of initiative. How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
You're asking me to conduct the interview, sir?
I am, young Phelps. You've only been with us a short time, and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record. Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from. But I'm curious as to whether you can turn your hand to interrogation. It takes a certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir. I think I am.
Good man. You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps. A motive, opportunity, hard evidence, and best of all, a confession. If you fail in the former, you can always use a modicum of violence to obtain the latter. How are you feeling, lad?
Fine, sir.
Very good. The evidence is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be eaten by the devil. Bring me a confession, young Phelps. This is your chance. Don't fail me.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. You followed Everett Gage and the girl back to the shoe store. You put 5 rounds in Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got what was coming. But it had nothing to do with me.
So you shot this guy over the sale of a watch.
You think Jewish people are going to continue to take it lying down? Straight in orderly lines to the ovens? Not this heap. I say enough is enough. No more. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps. Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. You followed Everett Gage and the girl back to the shoe store. You put 5 rounds in Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got what was coming. But it had nothing to do with me.
You shot Gage, and we know why. We can put you at the scene.
You can't prove anything.
We know all about the argument. Miss Galetta made a statement.
You're counting on the girl? You think her testimony's gonna stand up in court?
You're going to the gas chamber, Edgar.
That Jew-hating fuck couldn't leave me alone. I had a sale. That girl was ready to buy.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker. How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You left-wing leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those names, you goddamn goy butt snatcher! You and that stump Gage!
Why did you do it, Mr. Kalu?
Gage. He's in the Chamber of Commerce. He's in with all those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for years.
Edgar Kalu, I'm charging you with the first degree murder of Everett Gage. I respect your beliefs and your right to hold them. I hope for your sake, the jury can commute to murder in the second degree. May God have mercy on you, sir.
Masterfully done, Officer Phelps. It is just Officer Phelps, isn't it, lad?
Yes, sir.
Then let me have a word with the Chief of Police, young Phelps. The department needs heroes. A shining, honest face the public can admire. I applaud a man with your talent for unwavering justice. Back to your duties for now, Boyle. But here's a piece of advice. Get yourself two suits, get them pressed. You'll be needing them.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective. He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out. And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
that's
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. You really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why are you war heroes always so modest? I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside now. I'm gonna start you out with one case. Do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps. One,
He ran the light on Olympic. We finally collared him on the temple.
What do you think?
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
That's a guy from the papers. Solved that big case.
Mary says he'll sing, but only if I guarantee he walks.
You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gas works and Signo Depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct.
All units of 159 just occurred at 6th and Ceres. Any unit to handle, code 2, identified.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps.
Are we friends now, Bukowski?
We have to work together. Don't be so touchy.
I grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Reno CS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the Okinawa campaign. I was wounded. Shipped back home. Did a year on the beat. Now I'm here.
So you won the Silver Star.
I don't want to talk about it.
Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready. You finished?
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Fuck you, folks. I earned a bravery citation during the Zuta riots.
Sounds like you had it rough.
I did my job.
No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years as a patrolman.
That's the third time you've told me.
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Ceres. Any unit to handle, code 2, identify.
11K, go ahead, KGPL.
11K, a 459 suspect just left 6th and Ceres. Suspect is a male Caucasian.
Up on the roof, officer. He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
Now, make it easy on yourself.
Get the hell away from me.
Get down!
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stick.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police. How's the world looking?
Doc? Detective Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
I think I've seen it all.
Happier times, I guess.
Two years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here? Brand name might give us something to go on. Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday. Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars that park here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
We're going to notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
Can you drive to this one?
So where do you want to go?